Hi everyone, welcome to the world of sociology. In the last session we were discussing about Emil Durkheim, was one of the founding fathers of sociology, and we have been dealing with sociological theory from the Durkheimian point of view. As we have stated, Emil Durkheim was one of the founding fathers who played a crucial role in initiating a new perspective into the domain of sociology, and Durkheim has contributed substantially to the development of a functional perspective in sociology. We have been discussing about the concept of solidarity, which is also known as social solidarity of Emil Durkheim, and we have already covered the Durkheimian perception of mechanical solidarity. And in this session, we would be dealing with the Durkheimian notion of organic solidarity, and we would be making a bird's eye, we would be beginning with the new theory of Durkheim, one of the most famous theoretical perspectives of Emil Durkheim, and that is suicide. So what is organic solidarity? When Durkheim started proposing a solidarity for a modern urban agglomerate, for a modern so-called civilized and an urban society, Durkheim brought in the key word, that is organic. What is actually an organic system? An organic system consists of several interdependent parts which work together in harmony and in tandem with each other in a harmonious manner for the preservation, the continuation and the existence of that social system. When it comes to a society, again, if we take a modern urban society, say for example a city, where the type of solidarity is organic in character. It is not a solidarity of resemblance, like what we see in mechanical solidarity, rather it is a solidarity of differences, where people are different, they have different interests, they do different professions, they look differently, they have been hailing from different socio-cultural and economic settings, but they live together in a common area, they live together in a common space, and they are having a sense of belongingness, but of course in a limited manner, and the nature, students please note, the nature of their relationship is formal, it is secondary, and it is highly specialized in character, in the sense that the relationship is never primary or it is never informal, and they do different type of tasks, but at the same time they need to depend on each other for their living. You take your own house, say for example, if there is a problem with regarding your water supply, if there is a problem regarding your electrical system, you need a specialist to deal with that problem. Even if the problem is very minor, you will not be repairing or you will not be dealing it with your own, but you need a specialist, a person who is skilled to deal with that peculiar type of problem. Even if it is a health problem, you will be approaching a specialist. Imagine you have a problem with your ears. Say for example, you may not be approaching a general physician today, you would be approaching a person who is specialized in dealing with the ear as well as the related systems. This shows the degree, the extent to which this type of solidarity is based on differentiation. It is based on distinctiveness. That is the peculiarity of organic solidarity, which is opposite to that of mechanical solidarity, which we discussed in the previous class. So these are the two types of social solidarity, which is the Durkheimian conception, and Durkheim, through initiating the theory of social solidarity in the domain of sociology, Durkheim was actually giving a spark. He was actually giving a spark, an introduction. He was unveiling a new segment, a new theoretical segment in sociology, and that is functionalism. Anyway, we'll deal with functionalism later. Of course, we would be moving into the next important theoretical domain, perhaps the most popular, one of the most popular theories of Emil Durkheim, and that is the theory of suicide. Today I will be giving you a brief outline, an introduction into the theoretical perspective of Emil Durkheim or Durkheimian conception of suicide. Actually, what is suicide? This is an important question. And why do people commit suicide? This question has been pondering, has been seriously affecting the thought process of a number of people, and many people like academicians, thinkers, philosophers, doctors, psychiatrists, everyone commented on why suicide happened. And Emil Durkheim, of course, as a sociologist, tried to understand, tried to know, tried to verify, tried to analyze sociologically why people commit, people end their lives, and why do they take such a decision, and what are the prominent factors, I would say social factors, sociological factors, responsible for people committing suicide. Durkheim, before bringing out his theoretical perspective, which was a groundbreaking work in the history of sociology, attempted to research extensively on the phenomenon of suicide, I would say the phenomenon of suicide, and he conducted studies. He collected statistics on suicide from different European countries, compared them, classified them, analyzed them, and went through very close scrutiny of the same to assess and to analyze the factors responsible for why people are committing suicide. And then Durkheim came out with this very popular theory on suicide, as well as the four major types or the four major forms of suicide. Thank you.